The July 9th, the July 24th, and the July 31st minutes. Do you have a motion or any discussion on those?
Make a motion to approve.
All in favor?
Aye.
Okay.
I will vote aye on the middle 7 minutes. I was not present at the other two, so I will abstain.
I'll note that. The next item I want to go over is the financial report. I'll answer your questions the best that I can. Just bear in mind, I am relatively new to this as well. I've been working the past couple months with the finance officer, and this was the sheet that her and I come up with, and I want to briefly go over that with you. The first that you see on the tax report is, it says the TDA has a carry forward of $23,756.43. Now, the last disbursements are invoices that have been paid as of July the 31st, 2012. The ones, because we've started the new fiscal year. The ones we've paid are for Allison Outdoor Advertising for $1,300, and we get two bills a month for Allison. The second bill is for $520, so each month we pay Allison Outdoor $1,820. So the remaining balance that we have to work with as of date is $21,936.43. If you'll follow down where it says less commitments, that is what the board has voted to fund thus far, but we've not paid that yet. And the reason we've not paid it is either it's still in the middle of its contract or we've not got invoices for it as of Friday. The first one is the Comcast, and this contract includes the scope of work for Tony Angel and Michael Rogers. So really three bills come from that. This was approved for up to $50,000. Currently, from that, we still owe $22,325, and that is through October. The next item you'll notice is the billboard contract. Each month, again, we pay $1,820 per month. This is a yearly contract that's been renewed. The TDA still owes for 11 months, which we still owe. It's going to be $20,020. And then the other thing, a good thing to note, is anytime we do a billboard as far as changing the poster or approving a poster for a festival, there is a cost associated with that. And dependent upon the design, it averages anywhere from $125 up to the high end of $200. It normally falls somewhere in between. So just keep that in mind, that when we do the billboards and we give them to the different organizations, we are paying a poster fee, if you will. The next item is for Tony Angel, the billboard work and web page maintenance. That was for $800 per month. From the understanding, this is a yearly contract, and the TDA still owes for 6 months, which is $4,800 we still owe to Tony. Next is the Smoky Mountain Theater grant. I believe the TDA approved this back in February or March. I'm not 100% certain. We've yet to receive the invoice as of today, so we do still owe $10,000 to Smoky Mountain Theater. The next item you'll see on your financial sheet is the Smoky Mountain Rumble balance. As of now, we still owe them, out of the $14,800 budget, we owe them $5,640. The last grant that we approved was for Franklin Main Street Pumpkin Fest, which is for $2,000, which we have committed to that. The items I just went over, what we've committed to, so our total commitments thus far that we still owe for is $64,785. The total budgeted for expenditures for this current fiscal year, 2012-2013, has been $100,000. The TDA took in a little over $100,000 in revenue last year. So I'll try, like again, I said I'll try and entertain questions the best I can, and if I don't know the answer, I will try and get you an answer. Do I have any questions?
So basically, if I can paraphrase it, so basically the $64,000 leaves us about 36,000 left surplus in the budget.
Yes.
For next year at
yes.
this point.
Okay. Any other questions?
We have not shown any income so far this year.
Right, those, that will be available.
That doesn't come in, that won't come in, and it's not due until
August 15th. So we'll have that figure at the September.
We'll see that number show up.
Yeah.
And Summer, you were saying before that this doesn't include the reserve that's been built up.
This doesn't include, no, and this is my understanding of the reserve. The reserve, you guys voted back around 2008, from the best research I can gather, is to keep, each year, to keep 25% back in reserve. At this point in time, the reserve is around $89,000 in reserve. But keep in mind, the reason, one reason I didn't reflect that on here, is the only way this can, the reserve, to my knowledge, can be spent is by taking a vote to really undo the reserve. The TDA board agreed to reserve the 25%, therefore the TDA's budget would have to be amended up to what we want to take out of the reserve. And the only way we can do that is to go before the Board of Aldermen.
I wasn't here in 2008.
I know, I've been trying.
I don't know how many of us were, or.
Yeah.
I'm just a fool. I was wrong. I was
curious as to the strategy there.
Well,
with
just
the reserve.
In the event that there would be some outstanding thing that we wanted to do, that was the purpose for establishing a reserve, that we had an uncommitted pot of money that was being held on the side, so that if something did come up, an event or something that was not budgetable at that time, then we had money that we could spend beyond the budget with an amendment that would allow that to occur. So
we didn't have much financial history at the time.
Yeah, we had zero history, so we didn't know how much we were going to get or anything. So we put a pot in reserve is basically what it was.
And this is some.
The board voted, sorry.
And anything you do prospectively anyway has got to be just on the hope that the funds come in the way, because if people have something, if the economy tanks and nobody's staying in hotel rooms,
the Comcast contract is basically a month-to-month contract. So, if we find that we're running short of money, then we can just stop it at any time.
And this is something Candy and I have talked about. Definitely going to be a topic for discussion at the retreat in October. This is something
we need to probably.
It's getting,
yeah. Because there's no sense, because then we'd be under pressure to spend that money. Mm-hmm. So at some point, we need to say enough's enough. Cap it.
Maybe 100 is that number? Because then you're looking at having the year-to-year budgets already set aside.
Yeah, we have 1 year of operation.
Yes.
So if nobody sold the hotel room here, I could still fund activities for a year.
Any other questions on that thus far?
On the billboards?
Yes.
On that fee? Mm-hmm. Is that just to create the poster, or is that the design? Yeah,
there's two fees,
125 to 200. I was just curious about that.
That is to change.
That's poster printing.
The poster printing. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah. Because as each organization carries forwards, we.
It's not designed at all.
Yeah, because we're already running the billboards. Right. And that's the 1820.
Okay.
Now, the one billboard, the 1300 is five billboards.
And the 520 is
two billboards. The 520 is.
And the billboards did go up about $10.
Yeah.
Per one.
Because it was like $250.
$250
each.
Now it's $260 each.
It's $260 each. And the five are what we float. We change the message on. The two are permanent billboards that are. That advertise the town of Franklin.
Right. Any other questions before we move on?
So basically, the $89,000 in reserve, that's untouchable unless we amend.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah, we have to, there has to be two deliberate actions. We have to make a recommendation or request to the town board to amend our budget to spend that money. So there has to be an action to approve it by this board, the expenditure, and then a request to the town board to expend it.
Okay, thanks.
Thanks, Mike.
Well,
you've been a big help, that's why I'm saying thank you.
Being the staff person,
for so many years,
yeah.
I appreciate your expertise.
I'm not exactly a neophyte, but I'm.
No, I appreciate that. Any other questions? Okay.
And I'd be, if you've got my email, everybody's got my email address, so if you have any questions that pop up, as to some of the back history, if Summer can handle it, I think I could probably do that.
All right then, moving on to policy and procedures. The only thing I had for that, if you'll notice at each of your places, Ms. Springer had requested, I guess at our last regular meeting, just a contact list for everyone. I've provided that. If your email, if you want to update that, just let me know and I'll get that corrected. Yours will say, okay, that's good.
It's not Dan, it's just
in.
Yeah.
Okay.
What's that?
Oh,
it's
okay.
And? Cat's in. It's an in, not the word.
And I've also pointed on there, or put on there, the terms when each of you were appointed and when it expires. We have two expiring terms coming up. That's Beverly Mason and Deb Heatherly. But that's all I had for the policy and procedures. Deb, Funding Evaluation Committee. Unfinished business, Sylvia. We were on here for an update on the bike rally. Don't see her in the audience, so we'll wait. We can come back to that if we need to. We'll go ahead with the new business. We'll go ahead and hear the grant request.
If you want to back up to the bike rally for just a second, I know I emailed it to you and Candy, but if you wanted to tell everybody that the certificates of insurance coverage for the town and the TDA did come through from the new policy they bought through a different agent. So everything seems to be in good shape for the rally. I know you won't meet again until then, and you're going to hear an awful lot of engine rumble between now.
Yeah.
You don't want you to have nightmares.
Thank you, John. The first grant request we have is for Christmas events. Ms. Linda Silk.
I'm not going to stand up. I'm going to sit from here because I think they're going to see me from where they are. Our Christmas events this year, again, will start on Thanksgiving weekend. On that Friday night, we have a tree lighting ceremony. Unfortunately, the tree that we have in the clock tower is no longer there. So we have purchased a new tree, and we will probably place it next to the gazebo. It will be a lighted tree, and we'll just put the ornaments that we had before on that tree. And we'll have the candlelight service across the street there in front of the courthouse. We serve free cider, free cookies. Last year we went through 36 gallons of cider and about 900 and something cookies. So that event has grown each year. The first year, I think Bonnie helped us the first year, and it was nothing compared to what it is now, so that's good. We've also, the candlelight service, I think the first year I bought about 250 candles. Last year we gave out over 600 candles for that service. And everyone doesn't participate in the candlelight service. Some people come over there, some people, you know, go to the stores and do other things. The next event for that weekend is Letters to Santa, and that's held in this room. We have Santa Claus, and we have cookies and apple juice for the kids. That's another event that has grown each year. We get letters. I answer all those letters, and we send them out. I think the first year I answered like 100. Last year was over 300 letters.
Well, that's it. I'm writing one.
So I'm going to need help this year.
Do you come through on them?
Yeah, I was gonna say.
Do you come through on them?
And one of them was really cute when this little girl asked for a job. But I checked the addresses on those letters that come in from Letters to Santa to sort of see where, you know, where people are coming from. They've got South Carolina, Georgia, Tennessee, Virginia. We do have some from up north, but we know those are probably people who are, you know, visiting family for that weekend. That takes care of Thanksgiving weekend. Then the next is Winter Wonderland, which is December the 7th this year. That runs from 5 to 9 o'clock. And the stores are open, and they serve refreshments. And we have free wagon rides. The last couple of years, we've done an ice sculpture slide for the kids, plus an ice sculpture demonstration. And that night is really a community night. We have the kids from South Macon come and sing. We're looking at some of the high school kids to come sing this year. The Carolines will be singing in this room. We'll also have the Niquassi Dulcimer singers, I mean, players for Winter Wonderland. So we have a lot going on for that. And I think that's about takes care of what's going on for Christmas.
And that's both of those events running 3,500?
Yes. Yes, and we have to continually change our ads from one weekend to the next. And we are going to do fun things to do in that.
Any other questions from Ms. Slope?
About how many, I mean, I probably don't know exactly, but you said letters from South Carolina and Georgia?
Mm-hmm. Oh, how
is
many
there like,
do you know?
I mean, is there?
There's, I can just tell you just, that I always keep track of the zip codes as soon as I see them.
I have a question on the request. Is this, I wasn't here last year, is it similar to last year, or is it increased or same?
Any other questions?
Okay. Thank you, Linda.
You're up again, though. Grant, small little break, wasn't it? Grant request for 4 holiday billboards, Linda.
I forgot when I looked at my pumpkin fest request last month to ask for 2 billboards for Pumpkin Fest and 2 for Winter Wonderland, which is what I usually ask for. At least 2 of them to be as far south as we can get it. I mean, what I do are town sponsored events, so anything you do is appreciated.
Any questions in regards to billboards for Ms. Slope? Thank you. Next, grant request for Nantahala Hiking Club.
Yes. I don't know where to start. We this one, the National Family Hiking Day for ATC, connected to the Appalachian Trail Conference. It started last year. We tried last year as we, this was a short notice, so we didn't properly advertise well, so we were flopped. So this year we tried some advertisement through the papers and flyers and different businesses. If you don't know our organization, the Franklin Hiking Club is affiliated with the Appalachian Trail Conference. Been here a long time. Rufus Morgan founded. And we have about 200 members. Our main purpose is to maintain the Appalachian Trail. We maintain from Georgia line to NRC about 60 miles on the side trails along the way. Also, the Standing Indian campground area, the trails, we maintain those trails. The other purpose is to promote the hiking. So last few years, we take children to fifth the graders to South Ball. So the main purpose of this family hiking day is to promote the hiking. So we try to listen.
Okay.
fund for advertisement.
And you're asking for $500 for advertising, right? Any questions for Dr. Choi?
Yeah.
Go ahead.
You said it kind of fizzled or lost the first year?
Yeah.
Was it last year the first year you tried?
First year with, yeah, right.
Okay.
Actually, I came back from a national conference with the leaders of Appalachian Trail like West Virginia, talked with other peoples. They fizzled as well. I talked with the person, Lynchburg, Virginia, he said, couple showed up.
So. Is this part of the ATC?
Right.
They're, did they help get you started, or
yeah,
do
they started that, right.
Okay. Do they help with any promotion?
In a sense, with the, through the web page or that.
Okay. And as far as like a rough schedule of events for what you
got? We're going to be at September 29th, is Saturday, about 9:30 at the Standing Indian Campground. I reserved the picnic area, the shelter. So that's where we have a start with some hiking 101 introductions and try to get some funds for some food and a drink. My experience, food always attracts people. So.
Oh yeah, definitely. You would attract me. Okay, cool. So it's like a little educational time.
Right.
Maybe like talk
and
about leave no trace,
right,
kind of thing.
Also, we'll have all the members will lead a hike at half mile, mile, whatever the participant want. They're talking, just very introductory hikes.
Thank you.
Doctors, as you may know, the TDA has been kind of feeling out its insurance situation, and so I'm just purely out of curiosity, does your club get insurance maybe through the Appalachian Trail?
Right, we the subject that came up with the Appalachian Trail and the affiliated clubs actually covered by Forest Service, National Park Service, and Appalachian Trail Conservancy. So one of them should cover those activities.
And I don't think with the level of involvement that the TDA is looking at here, it's, I don't know that that's nearly as much exposure as something like the bike route.
Right.
But I just out of curiosity.
No, good question.
So the only other question I would have, was there any thought to having an event like even in here, in this building, as opposed to out at Standing Indian?
Well, we tried to take a hiking trail,
or
take an actual hiking trail.
As an incentive to hike.
Right,
okay.
That's good.
That's good. Thank you.
Any other questions for Dr. Choi? Thank you, Dr. Choi.
Thank you.
Next grant request for the Smoky Mountain Center for the Fine and Performing Arts, Nikki Pond.
Yeah, I got it. I'm just gonna pass you all the new booklet for the remaining year. And just, as you all know, you're helping us with this weekend's event with Charlie Daniels and Kelly Pickler coming in. That's this weekend. And I just ran off a map just to kind of give y'all an idea the areas that the majority of the people are coming from, just so you all can get a sense if you just want to, this is Kelly Pickler and that's Charlie Daniels. You'll see there's quite a bit from Florida, Tennessee, Georgia, and North Carolina are our main areas for the weekend. And just to kind of give y'all a little idea about the number of people and where we're drawing from at the theater, we ran off a map just for June and July. And it's pretty much the same area, but you'll see that it's starting to trickle out a little bit to the west of us as well, which is really exciting. But that's just another map, so y'all can kind of see the vicinity of where the out-of-town people are coming. But we are, again, very excited about this weekend and about just you guys. My husband has been trying to get to work out the whole invoice y'all heads up with that. So that's all being worked out as we speak. But we are asking the TDA to consider sponsoring us again for our November events that are taking place at the Performing Arts Center. If you'll look, we have a very exciting, yeah, there are several different. One says Kelly Pickler on the top and Charlie Daniels. Sorry, it's a lot of maps, but I just thought it would be good for you guys just to kind of see where the majority of our people are coming from. You know, and even just over the summer, kind of the vicinity. And we're covering and it's starting to trickle a little, which is really exciting. And we're still right now staying, I think the last time when we asked you all for a grant, we were in the 60-65 percentile of the, you know, how many out-of-towners are actually coming in, and we're still in that vicinity now. So really, the people who are coming into the theater, they're more out-of-towners and towners that are coming to the theater, which is great, great for hotels and restaurants, just the businesses across Franklin in general. But we are asking if you all would consider to, you know, possibly sponsor us again for our just the whole month of November. So instead of, you know, picking two concerts like you all did in August, it would be a whole month of saturation with the TDA logo and that type thing on all of our events for the month of November. We are starting out with Chubby Checker, which we're super, super excited about. He's the one who came up with the twist and the twist song and all that good stuff. So, and we go on in, we can break down into a twist. The Lowe family is, I was watching their video actually this afternoon. They are a very, very talented family. They've traveled all around the world. They do anything from Broadway, bluegrass. They do different styles of dancing, instrument playing. We're super excited about having them in November. The Overlook Theater Company is putting on the show You're a Good Man, Charlie Brown. You would be surprised the number of out-of-towners we get for the Overlook Theater Productions, which is fantastic. So that will be on a Friday and Saturday night during the November. And we are also doing this three mornings for the school children, just to let you all know. And there's schools from Georgia that actually come up here as well. And then we go with Sandy Patty. She's doing her Christmas show, so that's kind of, she's more or less opening our Christmas season. And Jason Crabb will also be with her touring, so this is gonna be a pretty huge concert we're super excited about. And to end November, the Hoppers, which is a gospel group. So that's what's taking place in November. Love for you all to consider the opportunity again. We've loved working with you guys. Y'all supported us for this upcoming event, and it's a great way. Your name has been very well saturated in all of our advertising. So, do you have any questions or anything?
Of course I have a question.
That's fine.
How are the sales for Charlie Daniels and Kelly Pickler?
Charlie Daniels, as of this morning when I looked, we were about 850, which he'll hit over 1,000 for sure. Kelly's over 1,000, so we're really hoping it'll be close to sell out for her. So, yeah.
Any other questions for me?
The only thing is the sin, how much penetration there is in Florida. We don't know if that's second home people or not.
We don't. What we're finding out too, though, a lot of the second home, they actually use their address here for the summertime. So that's, I can't say that for every person on the sheet or not, but you know, we've noticed that a lot of people, just so they can receive information, they do put in their second home addresses for the summer. So I think you're going to get it probably across a little bit of it on that.
Excellent. Thank you.
You're welcome. Thank you.
Any other questions? Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, the next item we have is grant requests for downtown businesses.
Hi, I'm Martha Holbrook, I'm in Rosebud Cottage on Main Street. I'm a downtown merchant, and I have Tony Hernandez here with me from Life's Bounty. We have been working on a street frisk project, which is a block party once a month on a Friday night. We hope that enhances everything else that's been going on, and it pulls people in after they've done their hiking and their rafting and having their fun day. I think you have probably in front of you our application. Some of the things that we will be offering at the street fest is the stores will be open for shopping. There'll be food. We have bands on each end of town. And then at the conclusion of the evening, we'll have a movie, outdoor movie, shown on a 26-foot screen here in this parking lot. So that'll conclude the evening. The marketing that we do is has been in the newspapers, the radio. We use social media a lot because that's free, basically. But it works, and we have some charts there. I think it's attached to your application that kind of show you that we'll talk about in a minute. We are trying to focus on bringing in some younger families in the age range of 24 to 44 to help grow our population and base in the town that are future tourists. And so that seems to be working pretty good. The next August is the next street fest in September and October. So those are the next projects that we have in the plan. Let's see, we've had some improvements from our last one that have been asked that we provide more food. So Tony and I and a couple of the other folks on the street are stepping up for that, and we'll be offering more dinner items, and so there'll be more than just sweets and that kind of thing, so we'll have food for that. The bands needed another stage so that they wouldn't be on the grass. That's one of the other things that we are working on to make that happen too. And I just want to quickly go over the chart here that we have showing on our Facebook page. Do you all have that in your notes there? We have 267 likes on there, and then there's 69, almost 70,000 friends of people who like this page. So they're seeing the advertising that we're doing. And as long as people click and share, then that people talking about that goes up. So that helps us spread the word. This time we plan on doing some measuring how many people are there at the street fest. We are going to have some youth do some counting for us, and we'll have some reports on that after this next program. And then the next page shows you some of the places that people are looking at us from. There's, of course, locally, Asheville, Atlanta, Silva, Charlotte, Holloweat, Florida, Raleigh. There's a whole list of where people are taking a look at what we're doing. So we are asking for some help on pulling this together and making this happen.
How is this different from the Picking on the Square event that happens on Saturday night?
We're trying to get people to wander up and down the streets. Picking, pretty much, people come and bring their chair and they sit, and there's vendors that are outside vendors that come in, and it's pretty much a contained event there at the end of town.
I can say one comment. On the street fest, my business building, on Picking on the Square, it doesn't.
And do all the downtown businesses stay open for this?
For this street fest, yes.
I have a question. I think you may address it in the beginning. Is this Venture Local? Is that what you're asking for on behalf of Venture Local? Or because I know they're the main sponsor of the street fest, am I correct?
The Venture Local is a citizens group that has helped put some ideas together to help us promote this and get some things going. So it's this request is from the downtown merchants.
You can probably guess I'm going to ask you about insurance. And whereas I don't see a whole lot of exposure to the town when it's a hiking group that's going to meet on San Dimini and they're not even here. We just paid for a little advertising. It's different when you're talking about stages and using some town property. And so walk me through that a little bit. Is anybody looking at special events coverage for?
Have not done that yet.
I think you should. I think the experience that we just had with the rally is told us that it's really not that hard to get. It's really not that expensive. And to just charge into it without any, especially when you're going to set up stages and you see the potential for liability there, that I think you better get covered. And I would hope you could do that in a short enough period of time. One of these is this week or this weekend. Mm-hmm. I don't know that you get it done in that short period of time, but I think you need it.
And now you're asking for 6,000, 3,000, or excuse me, 2,000 per event? Mm-hmm.
The movie and the screen is our biggest cost so far.
What are you gonna do for advertising?
We did some ads in the newspaper, radio, and then on social media.
And is the downtown businesses, is it an organization or a new organization?
We're putting together the Main Street again, downtown merchants.
And I need to ask the TDA a question about this particular one. It's maybe me playing catch up a little bit more, but when a request like this comes in, it's for 6,000, and of that 6,000, I see 700 that's advertised. Mm-hmm. The session law that allowed the creation of the TDA says 2/3 pretty much for advertising, 1/3 for other, tourism related expenditures. Is somebody keeping up? I mean, so if you break that down on a request by request basis, you are more than 2/3 are going to,
yeah.
I'm sorry, more than 1/3 of the expense here is going to not tourism, not advertising. Going to tourism-related expenses as defined in the session law. So is anybody keeping up with that division?
Yes. I hope so. I'm hoping at the board retreat that something else we need to address is to look maybe more closely at the funding request.
Because I don't think you need to be tied into saying, no, we're only going to grant this if it's 2/3 for
right,
advertising and 1/3
right.
for this other, because there are going to be differences.
Scenario. Yeah.
Sometimes it's going to be all expenditure related and not advertising.
Right.
Part of the movie is advertisement, because there's going to be like the TDA, whatever, whoever sponsors that, that's going to be presented at the time of the movie.
Well, we don't have anything to sell, so
right.
I mean, the acknowledgement of where the money comes from is important, but the fact is that it's not a marketing ploy on our part, because we're not really selling anything. But I do understand what John is saying, and yeah, it hasn't been looked at closely before, but I think we need to make some adjustments. But we have things like Linda's billboards. I mean, that's an expense that is automatic. We have the annual billboard rentals that is automatic. We have what we're doing with Comcast, which is automatic, and we're by the time you add those up, we're well above 60%.
Right. And it may be that you're already locked into so close to that percentage that you couldn't go wrong the rest of the year with what's left anyway.
Yeah.
We'd be
talking maybe $1,000 either way.
We're just trying to add our little bit to make Franklin a destination for people to come to.
And we had a really nice turnout for the last one. It was a nice turnout. So we had a lot of people show up for it.
Any other questions?
I have one question. So it says the name of the organization is Downtown Businesses. Is it a organization, or is just the businesses, downtown businesses, gotten together? Do you see what I'm saying? If we're giving money,
yeah.
Are we giving it? Is it an organization that we're giving?
And honestly, that kind of ties into the thing about insurance and relating to the TDA. That I'm not telling you got to go out and, you know, become GM, but I do think that you got to. I think it would be better if you at least had an association, that you're an unincorporated association, but you have, you know, meetings and you have bylaws and you have officers who go out on behalf of the organization to do things like this.
And we are bringing back the Downtown Merchants group together, so we have that, we're reviving that.
Yeah, because I think that was an incorporated group at some point, I believe, it was incorporated. Did it get the 501c3?
I think
they were. They were not right. Okay, so you know, you don't necessarily have to reinvent that entire wheel, but at least have some official state standing, you know, where you've got an incorporation under state law.
And depending on how they did it, it's possible to revive a corporation that's defunct. And if they had one,
mm-hmm.
I mean, you probably have to redo a 501c3 application, but at least you can be reincorporated pretty quickly.
Yeah, and that could probably provide some guidance on that. And a lot of it could be just the same words.
Mm-hmm. They had the bylaws and everything on
You could use the same words.
Just curious, the WNC Outdoor Athlon,
mm-hmm.
that was partially funded by this board, correct?
Yeah, good question from Mike.
How about Outdoor 76?
Yeah, we paid the advertising.
For advertising,
That's all we did. Yeah. We didn't give them cash grant, we paid advertising.
Gotcha, I was just curious.
Yeah.
Okay.
Because it wasn't an organized. At the time, it wasn't organized as a business identity, and to just give it to individuals, we couldn't do that.
Okay, mm-hmm. It was solely advertising.
So we paid the ads,
gotcha.
Through the TDA instead of handing over cash.
And that's kind of the territory I feel like you're in with this one.
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
Yeah. We're about the same.
Any other questions?
So that's doable. Is that what we're saying?
Yeah, that's.
It's like something like advertisement.
Yeah, that's doable.
Gotcha.
I was
here during the last one. The streets were full. People were carrying shopping bags. I think from what I can gather from the merchants, there was a direct benefit. From it.
Yeah.
So.
Otherwise, Foggy Night is dead. Businesses are, you just don't have people. But something like that would attract people and maybe give a business.
Something, I mean, it looks like it's over a period of time, so it's consistent. Something
mm-hmm.
consistently going on.
Any other questions?
Oh, thank you guys very much.
The next item, grant request for advertising and dashboard and saddlebags. I'd ask that we remove that and maybe postpone that for the September 10th meeting. I received a phone call this morning from Mr. Kent, who was interested in proposing this advertising opportunity to the board. And he had an emergency and wasn't able to make it tonight. So if we could table that. The next item under new business is the board retreat scheduled for October the 8th, 2012. You guys would make note of that. That is our regular scheduled TDA meeting. Instead of doing business, we'll use that as a retreat opportunity at 5:30. So if each of you will make note of that.
I can't make that.
You can't make that one. Thank you guys for each of you that came and had a request, you're more than welcome to stay. We will be voting on all those tonight. With that being said, I'm going to ask the town attorney, since he's here, if he has any advice for the board as far as rules of procedure and funding. I know we kind of have addressed some of those throughout the conversation tonight, but before we move into the actual voting procedure.
I think I'm still getting up to speed about how the TDA has been operating, and I will definitely have some of those for that October retreat. I think that certainly everything's been within the lines before. I don't see huge problems.
We've been watching that. I mean, the TDA has been aware of the limitations, and it's been acting within those in that case.
Right.
So, in most cases.
Well, I'm looking at every request with that in mind. We have to, that our main focus, as we determined at that last retreat, was for advertising.
And some requests have been funded to the levels of the worldwide.
Sure.
Or funded at all due to the way they termed their proposal.
Yeah.
By that October meeting, I want to have for you a firm answer about what exactly the TDA's coverage is, for at least for directors and officers under the town's policy, or if it may cost something to get the TDA added. I'm still working through that with Y Insurance. I think we'll have everything this board does here covered. I still think the recommendation is going to be to start requiring everybody to show you as they come in and apply for funds. What's your organization? What's your insurance coverage look like? You either have an ongoing umbrella that covers your organization, period, and if so, you'd like to see the town TDA, covered as an additional insured, or get special events covered.
That could be a page on the application.
Yes. Mm-hmm. I'd like to see that as a check off.
Okay.
Yeah.
And require that before funding is allotted?
Yes, exactly.
Okay.
Yep. But I'll have some more things about it at the meeting.
Thank you, John. Okay, with that being said, we'll go into the voting process of the grant request. The first item is for the Christmas event, Linda Sloat, $3,500. Any discussion amongst the board?
I was at those events last year for the first time, and this time was packed with people.
It's well attended. I've went for the past couple of years.
Is that a motion?
That's a motion.
I'll second.
The next item would be the. I'm so sorry. Then you guys left. Excuse me. So we had a motion. All in favor? Any opposed? All in favor?
Aye.
And opposed? Sorry, trying to write and do takes a little. Trying to multitask here. Okay, the next item, since I got ahead of myself, is the holiday billboards request, two for Pumpkin Fest and two for the Christmas events. Any discussion amongst the board on those two or four requests? Okay, we do.
Yeah, we don't have anything after Ruby Bash.
I'll second.
All in favor? Any opposed?
Alright. Just a note, can I add a note on the billboards?
Sure.
Those posters are guaranteed for a month, basically. The Smoky Mountain Rumble board has been in a state of disrepair, and I have turned in one work order to get that repaired, and it's back falling apart again today. So I will more than likely call Nelson Bumgarner with Allison and have him go over and patch it up so it'll hold through to the weekend. He He said one of the main problems with that was is using the color black on the paper. It draws extra heat and therefore adds to a quicker deterioration of the paper posters that they put up there. So I will call Nelson tomorrow or actually text him or email him tonight and let him know if they can just patch it together one more time till we can get through this weekend. And I'll do that. But those posters usually last about a month, and if you have to replace them, of course, that's $125 to $200 a pop to put a new poster up for.
I thought those were 90-day, you were buying 90-day posters, and they were good for 90 days, and they wouldn't repair them. I know the vinyls
are good for 3 years.
Yeah.
Nelson told me they would last about a month, really, if that's about all they guarantee. But I can double-check that.
Okay, because they told us it was a 90-day poster.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that
they would replace them if they went bad within that 90-day time.
Because they've been asking me how many posters we want to order, and of course I always just put down one because it's not my money to spend. So I always just put down one poster, and then if they needed more, they could contact a candy or someone to count on us.
Yeah.
Thank you for letting me know.
Thank you, Dr. Brody, all you do with them. Okay. Next item, request for the Nantahala Hiking Club, $500. Discussion from the board.
Since this is a first event, I think we should endeavor to see this go. I would suggest that that the TDA pay the advertising cost.
This is all showing every bit of it going to advertising.
I agree with Mike. I think it's a new event. It's something we should help, but it's all going to advertise.
Have them bill us for it, and that would work.
Yeah.
And then we'll see what the results are. If they get any turnout, if they don't, then they can make a decision if they're going to do it next year or not.
Is that a motion?
Your motion is that they turn the bills into us and that we will pay them up to
$500.
Up to $500 for
advertising. Do we know what outlets? Did we go over that? What outlets
they use to advertise? They're talking about regional news. I don't know.
Don't get me wrong. I love this. I mean, I really like the idea of it. Okay.
Yeah. So, that's... We're giving them what they requested. It's just, mm-hmm. You know,
right, gotcha.
We can pay for it instead of just handing the check over.
Right.
And then that way we've got some documentation as to where their money was spent, how regional it was. Mm-hmm.
So Mike's got the motion. Do we have a second?
Second.
Discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? The next item, grant request for the Smoky Mountain Finance Performing Arts Center, $10,000. Discussion from the board.
I have a question. Have they come before us before?
They have.
And is this same amount?
Mm-hmm. This was something it's relatively new that we've done. The most recent one we did was the Kelly Pickler and the Charlie Daniels, where we sponsored, again, the same amount for $10,000. I think it's a wonderful idea. I don't know if it's within the board right now to look at that cost at the moment, or maybe look at it maybe in the future. But that's for board discussion.
The Charlie Daniels event, and the reason that's mentioned was in relationship to the motorcycle.
Yes, thank you, Mike.
So that was a purpose-specific
event. Yes,
perfect.
Thank
you. I think Sharon and Scott, Sylvia and Scott, worked it out with the performing arts to have it, because there wouldn't be any venue that we could host that kind of an event at other than there. And, you know, so... That would be a tie for them to have something to do, I believe, on Friday and Saturday night.
Right.
And is that what's represented here in the already committed?
That's the
$10,000. Yes, that's the $10,000
that
we voted, that this board voted on back February, March. But see, we still haven't paid the first $10,000 because we've not got an invoice yet.
Right. So they won't be billing us probably for till after we've done more than like that.
We don't know. I mean, they can turn around tomorrow and get it.
This is our second commitment then, is that?
This would be our second.
This would be the second, this would be.
We did have, and just to be 100% honest, we did have some issues with sponsorship of some events that they had in the past. We did pay for a billboard for a while.
Twice.
2 years, I think we paid for that. That was about $12,000 a year, but it's in a location on what would be 985 extended coming up to Franklin.
I think your point about we're not selling anything with the TDA logo on the ads and
we're,
stuff.
I mean, we're selling the town of Franklin.
Right.
Right. Well, that carries no weight.
We have no specific product. Yeah.
I'll make a motion to table it. I mean, we're already committed.
I'd second
grand.
That motion.
And you know, I mean, theater's great and it brings in a lot of folks, but you know, one of the things is this Charlie Brown thing. You know, that's appeals to a lot of local folks.
It does.
Yeah.
I think that limits.
But the part of the thing is, and I'm the only one here that way out there to bed and breakfast, my wife and I. That's not news, but the thing is that we do get, I would say probably over the course of the year, probably 10% of our business is people that are coming for a conference that know the hour the conference ends and don't want to drive home. So they're coming up from Georgia, Tennessee, Virginia to see a specific event, and they do spend time here. So I'm not saying that 100% of the people that show up on that map are not just going home from here, but there is a percentage that does. They eat a meal in a restaurant. They're here for the event, and they spend the night. So I mean, there's some positive impact to that.
Gotcha.
I think one question you've also got to get answered about how this one's going to work is that, as it should be, the TDA requires logos and attribution for your money, but they already printed this thing. Are they going to go back and reprint it for November if you?
It's a good point.
Yeah. So where all is the logo and the name?
Well, on the advertising that they'll be doing on whatever. If they're doing radio ads or TV ads, they'll should throw our sponsorship on.
I think another concern we had before when our yearly budget is only about $100,000, give or take.
This is
10%.
Well, that's already 10%. Another 10,000 makes it 20% of our yearly budget. Do we want to put all our eggs in one basket, so to speak?
Big chunk of money.
It is.
Right. I'll second my motion.
Okay. Any further discussion?
So we're tabling it for the purpose of. After the retreat, discussing it at the retreat, or what's we're tabling it to how long, or for what purpose?
Should we table it, John, or if it seems it's the.
And that's the motion?
Well.
Should we table it, or if it seems no one's in favor, should we go ahead and.
What I'd suggest is table it until the retreat. Now, if we can have the majority of the board at the retreat, then we can get better direction. Here we're operating with three people gone.
Agreed. And considering what I'm showing here for funds, available funds, and we still don't have our numbers.
Yeah, but we haven't started receiving for this year.
Right.
So.
I agree. I'd like to have it maybe discuss it for retreat because I'm not ready to vote. I'm not ready to vote against it.
Right.
And I'm sure $10,000 is probably a drop in the bucket overall for what they do, but it is a big chunk.
I think I will phrase the motion as postpone discussion on that matter until the October meeting.
Okay. I mean, we're not ruling out funding them, but
yeah. I'll make a motion to postpone the discussion for the Smoky Mountain.
I will say
Center for Performing Arts at the summit in October.
Okay.
motion, Mike, you have the second.
I'll second that.
Any further discussion? All in favor? Any opposed? All right, the next item, grant request for downtown businesses, $6,000. Board discussion on this one?
I like the idea of what they're trying to do. My only concern is maybe what the attorney said about the liability.
That is a question I did have for John as well.
But I mean, I'm all in favor of that. I think it's a great idea.
Given what we just kind of went through, and I saw on here, I believe the first be September, this Friday, or I'm a month ahead. This Friday in August would be the first.
How the thing about liability is, number one, a plaintiff's attorney, which I don't think in that realm, I'm a defense attorney, but a plaintiff's attorney would have somebody falls off a stage, they're going to sue everybody they possibly can. And the problem is, if you don't, you know, first, if it's an incorporated association or some kind of corporation that comes and sponsors that, there's your first line, and you know they're going to get sued. As it is, I think they drag every business at any part in it, in any way, shape, or form, into court on that.
And the town, for sure.
And especially if it's something that happens on town. If it happens on town property, I guess I have a little more confidence that the town's existing policy would cover it. Mm-hmm. But I think if it didn't happen on town property, it would be, they're going to name the TDA, and they're probably going to name the town.
This happens on town property.
It's not exclusively, is it? Isn't it all up and down the street?
Well, what's
it's downtown.
Where does town property end?
Downtown.
Well, there's private property.
Where in the town? I'm talking
downtown?
About town-owned property.
Yeah.
The town doesn't own the sidewalks and maintains them. It doesn't own the streets.
Well,
you know, so if you go ahead.
Where's the movie going to be shot?
And my only point is, I'm pretty sure that the town's existing policy would cover an occurrence on a claim that happened on town-owned property. But the town only owns, like, you know,
this
block
building
here.
This property. It's going to take place.
The movie's going to be
right here.
Right here on our property.
Is it exclusively
on
this
town,
property?
On town hall
property.
Paper.
Yeah, the stage is going to be also in the parking lot.
Well,
it's
right here,
place parking?
No, it's in front of town hall, but it's on the grass.
I would feel more comfortable with it if it was an association of some kind that and had at least a special events policy for it.
Not wanting to totally turn them down. What if we just paid for the advertisements? Would that insulate us sufficiently?
Well, I think it helps, but you just invited the, when the person that falls off the stage does
right.
So, they came at your invitation. That's the way that
If we can get it by Friday, the insurance,
and you might be able to.
And try to reactivate that street program.
That's the only other kind of concern I had, was I would feel okay with doing maybe the September and October, but do we have time for the August?
I don't think that you'll be able to get this incorporation problem fixed. That's more like a couple months.
Yep.
Kind of process. I mean, it's not interminable, but it's going to be a couple months. The insurance thing can happen, but the problem is somebody's going to have to be the one. They're not going to write a policy that says downtown merchants.
Right.
You know, the insurance company won't do it. It's got to have some person. So you'll have to find somebody who's willing to be the person who bought that insurance policy and knows if the person falls off the stage, you know, I'm getting sued, and so is everybody else. But I think you could do it that way. I think. Now, and I'm not an insurance agent either, so you'd have to talk to one.
I don't know if I would be comfortable with the person. as opposed to an organization or?
It'd be better if it was an organization, yes. Than any doubt.
I'd feel more comfortable, yeah.
And we'll know who that person is because they'll be running around with a pillow.
Right.
But I think that you could approve an expenditure along those lines with the requirement that on the condition that a special events policy must be in place first. Of course, I don't know how that, it's all the insurance, all the advertising is before the fact.
Fact.
So.
That's the only issue I have.
I don't know. I have to walk around with a little rain cloud over my head and follows me everywhere I go. Probably nothing would happen, but I can't promise you.
Was the September, when is the September event? 28th. The 28th? Would it be more, how does the board feel maybe tabling to the September meeting? Because we'll have our meeting September the 10th.
Can I? Say something here.
Well, this is really allowed? Board discussion. Oh, we'll have a chance for the audience.
Okay.
I'm also looking at the request on adding $3,700 in an advertising cost. Mm-hmm. So we have a $6,000 request.
No, I'm less worried about the balance because of the, mm-hmm. even though it's over. It would be higher than what the amount would be because of all the other advertising that we do. I think we're well enough above that one-third. We're actually into that one-third on what we advertise for. So we have room to play a little bit on it. So it's not just advertising. You don't have to find just advertising, especially for this kind of money.
Yeah, it's at least two-thirds on advertising.
Right.
And then the remainder up to a third on everything else. So, like Mike said, if you go over that.
At this point, I'm
on advertising.
I don't know about the rest of the board. I'm just concerned about the insurance, concerned what we just went through.
Yeah.
We're spending just between Comcast and the rental of the billboards, we're spending $70,000.
Mm-hmm. Oh, and I'm sure
in this calendar year.
Yeah.
So that means we've got room to fund
What's the will of the board at this time?
Yeah, because you can get just an incorporation quickly, fairly quickly. I don't think that's as long drawn out deal as that's just filing papers with the state.
Go ahead, John.
There's a cute little cottage industry that the Secretary of State's office has in corporations where if you send the regular filing fee, it'll be about a month and a half. If you send a little bit more, they'll do it a little bit faster. If you send a little bit more, it'll be a little faster still. With my office, I have an uncle that lives in Durham, so we just send everything to him overnight and walks it into the office of the Secretary of State, puts it down and waits till he gets it back. So you can do it as fast as you can get to Raleigh and put it in the Secretary of State's hands.
All right,
we've got a motion. Is there a second?
I have one more question, if I may. Mm-hmm. I'll just ask you, John. You said if just for future reference, if things are being held on town property, that should be, my concern would be finding that out, number one. And if things are being held on town property and people come and they do leave town property and walk to somebody's store, they trip, fall, then who are they going after? Who can they go after? I mean, how's that different from a regular Saturday? Somebody walks down the street, walks into a store, trips, falls, wants to go after someone.
Once they leave the town's property, though, our liability, even though they've been invited to a town,
once they leave the town's property and go into a store, then it's all on whoever's property they're on.
Which is not to say you can't be sued, though. I mean, that's all. That's my favorite question: is can
so,
we be sued?
So
our liability just drops.
Yeah.
Yeah.
If they're in a store or something.
But, John, the town requires all festivals to have insurance. The folk festival had to have insurance. The Taste of Scotland had to have insurance. Because they were not town-sponsored festivals.
Right.
And that's something we've just done in the last couple of years. They have to have the band insurance.
And I think that, and like I was saying, that's what I think the TDA really needs to do for every event.
What do you look at for, what is that range, cost-wise?
I don't know because I don't do it. The festival does it itself.
Well, the special event policy that the motorcycle rally folks got was $784. Yeah. And that covers a 4-day period between the putting up the thing and taking it back down at the end and everything in between. You know, so it's a for that kind of an event and for that long a period of time. Only $700 and some odd, I wouldn't think it'd be all that much to cover this.
Yeah, for them for one evening.
Yeah.
But you're thinking it needs to one day. It either have to go under an individual or an organization to be insured.
Because they're not gonna they won't write a policy for just
Forgive my ignorance. But I'd just like to know about these things for future reference. So how's Winter Wonderland? Is that that's town-sponsored event, so it's under town insurance across the board.
Any event that I do is a town-sponsored, it's under town insurance.
Right.
So it's a town-sponsored event, it's covered.
Gotcha. Okay. Thanks. Right.
So we had a motion.
And a second.
Is there a second?
A second.
Further discussion? All in favor? To table.
Table to September.
To the September.
Okay.
Any opposed? Okay. Okay. Now, since we've covered all the new business, is there any items from the floor?
Well, that was just that didn't work. The problem is by September 10th, it can't be put together in those 11 days. Things have to be ordered. The movie has to be ordered 3 weeks ahead.
Well, what about this Friday?
This one's already paid for.
Okay.
But
you had a request for.
Well, I know to hopefully reimburse some of those people who have paid for things, but they can't. They can't pull it together in that time. Not knowing, not going into it, not knowing it. But
okay. Any other items from the floor?
But you know, Bynum, what I hear the TDA saying is they really like the event.
Yeah,
just,
I know.
You know, so
yeah, but how
so
we
can work,
how do we pay for it without having the commitment? And that's the problem. We've done it for 2 months now, but we don't have the commitment to do it.
All I can do is assure you that we're going to try to activate these things as fast as we can.
I'd like to say one thing about it. I have sometimes been a critic of the TDA, but I'm very impressed with the way y'all are showing professionalism and the headaches you're putting up with it, and I want to thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Scott. Any other items from the board? Okay. Announcements, the only announcement the board had was October retreat. And then our next regular scheduled board meeting will be September the 10th. And I must apologize from the beginning. Miss Presley is on vacation, so I am sucking in his chair. I should have done that at the beginning of the meeting, but excuse me. But she is on vacation. I'm subbing in his chair.
I thought it was just the power.
Oh. No. No.
Coup d'etat.
Miss Springer?
Okay, question on the retreat.
Yes, ma'am.
I guess when I hear the term retreat, I thought it was going to be maybe a whole day or so. Is it a regular meeting?
It would just be at our regular meeting time at 5:30 here at Town Hall.
Right.
And at that
do we expect it to go until whenever?
Till whenever.
Hours.
And it's just.
That's all questions.
It's just block out, but it is, it'll be at 5:30 here at Town Hall on October the 8th, and it will serve in place of our regular meeting.
Okay.
I'd like to request another date. You know, just speaking on my behalf, I'd like to be here.
Is there anyone else who can't make that date that we know of here tonight?
I can make it, but I was kind of curious if there was a poll or anything taken, or you just.
That's a
regular.
That's a regular.
Oh, okay, that's a regular date.
That's the regular meeting.
It's not like we've not done things outside of regular meeting times.
That's true.
Okay.
I mean, I've got the desire put into that, so.
Certainly, and we've got another month.
Right.
I can definitely relay that to Candy and maybe do a poll to see.
I'd appreciate it.
Yeah, that's no problem.
Do we want it on a regular meeting day?
And that's something else we can discuss. I know that she was just.
Because they were already committed.
Mm-hmm.
That's fine.
But that's definitely a request I'll look into. And we'll have something by the September meeting. Any other items from the board? Go ahead.
No, that's what I have to retreat.
Okay. Well, I'd like to thank each of you guys. We had a rather lengthy agenda tonight, and thank you for your attendance and coming. And with that being said, nothing else.
I would like to say one thing.
Oh, mm-hmm.
The numbers on the Facebook page that the merchants provided.
For
the street fest.
Oh, for the downtown business. Okay.
For
yes.
That sort of thing. That's good. I'd like to just for us to even request that here forward. Any kind of tracking like that.
Oh yeah, any type of. That'd be, yeah.
And that's something we can definitely discuss at the retreat. But that stuff makes sense.
One more time. Anything else? Motion. Is there a second? All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you, guys. Thank you.